Hey YouTubers, it's Miss Dominique and I am back at it again today. Yes, I went to Pinterest and got another great quote for you guys. Are you ready? Well, here goes. Not one drop of my self-worth depends on your acceptance of me. Wow. I think immediately I thought about a lot of our young ladies today and social media. I feel like, you know, social media plays a big part in society today. And a lot of times we see all these Instagram models and social media models, and we put in our mind that we want to be just like them. We want hair like them. We want bodies like them. We want the guys to look at us like them. But I guess I'm here to tell you today that your self-worth, which I'm going to tell you the definition of self-worth is the sense of one's own value or worth as a person. So the amount of worth you put on yourself, it doesn't have anything to do with anyone's acceptance of you. I think I went through a phase in my life where I did try to please everyone. When I was in high school, I was just that really nice, sweet, innocent girl who wanted to do any and everything for everyone. There wasn't ever a time that I would tell anyone no, even if that meant me jeopardizing something that I had going on, or even if I was just so tired, if anyone asked me to do something, I would just do it. So I think it wasn't until I got to college where I started realizing that not everyone would do me that same justice. Not everyone was going to do for me the same way I would do for them. Now, do not get my words twisted or confused. I'm not saying that I do things for others expecting things in return, but the same loyalty that I give to people, I guess I kind of expect that same loyalty in return. So I think I started learning and growing and maturing my early years of college to the point where I just kind of decided that if I couldn't do something for someone, I just wouldn't be able to do it. I wasn't gonna put myself out there if other people weren't going to put themselves on the line for me. And that wasn't in a mean way, it was just a part of me growing as an individual. So if a person didn't like me because I didn't do something for them, I think that that's the point I'm trying to make, that that person isn't a true, genuine friend to me. So that was just a lesson that I had to learn. And now in my older life, it just kind of is what it is. I am who I am. Either you're going to love me, like me, or hate me. And that doesn't make me determine that my self-worth is low. I am who I am. I'm Dominique. I have a confidence about myself that no one else establishes for me but myself. So I just think that it's important for us to get to that phase. Stop always aspiring to be like someone else. Stop always yesing and wanting to do everything for everyone. If you can't, just say no, and that's okay. Still be the best person you can be to people, because I am a people person. I am a people lover. I am actually a people pleaser. I love doing things for people, but I can't do it at the expense of my own happiness, my own sanity, my own time. Especially because I'm a mother and a lot of my time is taken up with my son. So, I mean, how dare I neglect responsibilities of my son or neglect things on my own or taking care of myself because I'm trying to do something for someone else who wouldn't give me that same gratitude in return. So, people's acceptance of you, it doesn't have anything to do with your self-worth. So I just want us to, like I say, I want to challenge you guys to dig deep and learn how to have self-acceptance, accept yourself for who you are. When the whole natural hair thing blossomed and became big again, I loved it because not everyone felt like they had to have bundles of hair down their back. And not saying anything's wrong with it because I love long hair, don't care. But I just felt like we were to a point of society where girls didn't feel like they were beautiful unless they had hair that was down their back. So when the whole black is beautiful, natural hair came into play, it allowed people to get in touch with their inner self. It allowed people to love themselves for their natural, kinky, coily, curly hair. And I just love that. I want us all to get to a place where whatever I want to wear, I want to wear it. I don't have to dress like someone else for acceptance. For instance, my friends and I, I'm always the one that's dressed just so lax, so comfortable. I don't wear a whole lot of jewelry. Now my other friends, I mean, gorgeous. They wear statement necklaces and cute earrings and bold rings and fingernails that are always cute and everything like that. And no slight to them. I love that. I tell them all the time, I wish I could be more like you, but kind of in a joking way, because I am excited that I am who I am. I don't necessarily need all of those things to make my self-worth higher. And my friends accept me for who I am. I accept them for who they are. I think they're beautiful and they think the same thing of me. So it's not like well, we can't be friends with Dominique because she's not on the same level of us. It's not that. It's just that Dominique is who she is and they accept me for who I am, and that is why they are genuinely my friends. So I want you guys to really start to assess the people that you have in your inner circle, making sure that you don't have to be someone else in order to fit in with them. Because if you have to be someone else to fit in with them, then I just really don't think that friendship is genuine. So again, just don't let anyone's acceptance of you define who you are as a person. It doesn't define your self-worth, okay? Guys, so just love yourself. Guys, love our women for who they are. Don't make them feel like they have to be a Kim K, and she's beautiful, but we don't all have to be her. They don't have to be a Beyonce, and Lord knows I'm a Beyonce fan to the day I die, but we don't all have to be a Beyonce. It's okay for us to be exactly who we are, and we want to just help love and encourage each other for the people that we are. All right, guys, that's it for today. I'll see y'all next week. I'm out.